He has an MSc and a PhD, and on his quest for the CMP, has already cleared his CMP level 1. He has been in the markets since 1992 and is using technical analysis since 2000. That's more than 10 years, I would say. He is a regular lead writer in Investment Weekly, Informed Investor, for over 2 years, and has more than 100 published articles on Weekly Technical Views in this publication. Also, Dr. Shanbag is the technical advisor for the proprietary firm Shanbag Consultancy Services, and has conducted more around 25 teaching programs on technical analysis and 6 programs on derivatives and derivative strategies. He has delivered lectures all over Mumbai in investor meets and colleges, and also conducted a large number of free educational seminars. So it's great that we have him amongst us today. So let's benefit from his insights and his expertise. So let's have Mr. Shanbag with us. Thank you.
Presentation done. I must tell you something, that though the topic given to me was use of oscillators in determining tops and bottoms, I am not restricted to oscillators. One component I am going to include, which is not necessarily oscillator, but I thought it would be important because it has to do with something like determining the bull market top, where to exit near the top. So I have included this. Now, whenever we are talking of tops and bottoms, it's always known that we use candlesticks, we use other parameters, and usually the oscillators are laggards in this context. But I beg to differ over here, especially when you are not talking of intraday, especially when you are talking of positional. Actually, oscillators can give you much more information, that also in advance. They give you an advance idea when you have to get out of the market. They give you an advance idea when to enter the market. Now, as I can see quite a few of youngsters over here, I would just quickly touch upon some of the issues which every technical analyst knows very well. First of all, when we say stock is going up, why does the stock go up? What do you think? Why does a stock go up? Simple question. So it's a general misconception. I will say misconception, that demand is more, or because people are buying, stock is going up. No. Stock doesn't go up just because there is demand. Let us take a simple example. Today, if I tell you I am going to sell you Reliance at 700 rupees, will you buy it? Any X, Y or Z, if I tell you 700 rupees, I am going to sell Reliance, will that fellow buy it or not? So demand is existing or not existing? Okay, demand is existing, but demand is existing at what price? If demand is at one price, at the most what will happen? Stock will not go below that price, but that doesn't mean stock will go up. When will stock go up? My buyer is here, my seller is here. Stock won't go up unless and until buyer says, okay, I'll go and match my price with the seller's price. My bid should be same as the offer, and when bid becomes equal to offer, bid goes and meets the offer. Fine, the deal is struck. Has the stock gone up? Marginally. That doesn't mean it will resume uptrend. The second offer will be at a still higher price. Now, there is a second buyer. If the second buyer decides, okay, I will go up and buy, then the stock price will start moving up. Or when demand starts going up, 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 demand starts going at, coming in at higher and higher price, that is important, that will take the stock up. So stock does not go up just because of demand. When does it go up? it goes up mainly when demand keeps coming at higher and higher price. Okay? In other words, a stock goes up only when buyers are chasing the stock. All right? This chase is important. If the chase is not there, the stock price simply cannot go up. At the most, what will happen? It will not fall. There is demand for Reliance at 900. Fine, Reliance won't go below 900, but that doesn't mean it will go up. Every time it is 900, the supply is absorbed. Okay. That forms a floor, but that doesn't take the stock up. So for stock to go up, buyers must chase the stock. Same way, exactly the opposite. Why does the stock price go down? Only supply doesn't make it come down. Okay? If I tell you as much stock you are going to give me at this price, I am going to buy. Fine, the stock price will not go, but then it will not come down. It will not go above that. Supply will keep on coming. Alright? So, same thing applies over here as well. That stock price does not go down only because there is supply. Supply at what price? If there is supply at current price, then the stock won't go up above this. It won't go down. It will go down only when supply starts going at lower and lower and lower price. Or, in other words, a stock goes down only when sellers are chasing the stock. So both the things are totally different. Not only that supply coming in. Supply coming in at reducing prices. That takes the stock down. Right? Now same way, what is a top? When is a top formed in the markets? All of us know top is first the prices have to rise. After that the prices have to come down. So prices go up, prices come down, and we get what we call a top. Okay, first up, then down. Naturally, when we are talking of a top formation, initially prices are going up, later on they are coming down, declining. Means for formation of the top, first the prices have to go up. When the prices go up, buyers chase the price, and when the prices come down, sellers chase the price. So unless this cycle is there, buyers chasing the price, then buyers and sellers will be balancing each other when the top is actually formed, and then the top is confirmed only when sellers start chasing the price, the stock price starts coming down yet again. That is what we call a top. Naturally, in the bottom, it's going to remain the opposite. First, the price must come down, and then the price must increase. Then you say the bottom is in place. Again, same cycle is going to continue here, opposite exactly. First, the seller should chase the stock. Then, selling and buying are compensating each other, so price stops falling. And then, the buyers are chasing the stock. Okay. Why does that balancing comes in? At the top, the price has initially increased, but then comes a value where buyer is not ready to go up, bid is not going to reach the offer level, and as bid doesn't reach the offer level, the deal is not stuck, it is standstill. Now no buyer is available. Jisko buy karna tha usne kar liya. Right? Those who wanted to buy, they have already bought it. And now there is no buyer ready to pay that higher price. So finally the seller has to come down. The next buyer comes up, say 5 to 10 paisa below this deal. The next seller comes further down.